Yo, 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 what's good, family? Welcome to PNP. It's your boy Rashad, one half of PNP, and today I'm here to talk about rookie expectations. And I know it's way, way too early, but I'm just giving y'all my thoughts. What's going on in my head? You like it or not? It is what it is. I'm just giving y'all my thoughts, okay? Now, before we get into this, man, make sure you hit that like button, hit the subscribe button, hit the notification bell. We're on the road to 50,000 subscribers on YouTube. We got a long, long way to go, but I'm dropping a lot of heat, and I'm hoping we get these subscribers up, all right? So let's get it. Hit the subscribe button for your boy, and if you want to help the channel out even further, go to Newsbreak. Download that Newsbreak app. The link is in the description box. Go follow us over there. We need to get to, like, 500 Newsbreak subscribers. So if you're a subscriber here, go and download the Newsbreak app. It's a local news app where it aggregates all the local news, and you can also catch PNP over there. Helps us out a lot. Go hit the subscribe button or the follow button over there. Go like our videos, the same stuff, but just help us out, all right? I appreciate that a lot. All right, let's get into it. First up, we got J.C. Horn taken in the first round, 8th overall in the draft this year, and he was the first defensive player taken. Why am I putting such an emphasis on that? Because over the past two seasons, the first defensive player taken has won the Defensive Rookie of the Year award. Not saying it's going to happen with J.C. Horn, it just has happened over the past 2 years, okay? And it's happened before that too, okay? So, it's really tough to win it as a cornerback though. Since 1967, there's only been 8 total cornerbacks that have won Defensive Rookie of the Year. However, the NFL is changing. It's becoming a passing league. It's giving more opportunity to those guys to win the award. So much so that it's happened twice recently. Marshon Lattimore, Marcus Peters. Both of those guys have ended up winning Defensive Rookie of the Year. Now let's take a look at what it took for those guys to win that award. Marshon Lattimore, 5 interceptions, 11 pass breakups. Marcus Peters, 8 interceptions, 18 pass breakups. I remember Marcus Peters' rookie year, and that dude was an absolute beast, okay? He was killing out there. And that's a lot of interceptions, a lot of pass breakups. And it's all going to depend on how quarterbacks treat him his rookie season. J.C. Horn could be treated as a rookie, and they could go at him. It is a really, really tough position to transition to from college. It's tough. Ask Jeffrey Okuda. I know he was dealing with injuries, but it's tough. It is tough to win the award as a cornerback. And if they treat him as a rookie and go at him, then he's got to man up. He's going to get a lot of opportunity to prove and get those interceptions and get those pass breakups. But if they treat him like a lockdown cornerback that we think he is and they shy away from him, it's going to be a lot more difficult. And me personally, I think it's going to be a combination of both. I think that he's going to get picked on early, but at the end of the day, when the season moves on towards the end of the season, and the tape mounts up, they're gonna be like, nah, we can't go with this dude. He's a real deal. He looks the part, he plays the part, and he is who we thought he was gonna be. And they're just gonna be like, nah, we're not gonna go at him like that. So I think it's gonna be a mixed bag. That being said, my official stat prediction for J.C. Horn, I've got 3 total interceptions, and I've got 10 pass breakups. 3 interceptions, 10 pass breakups for J.C. Horn. And I think that akins to kind of Jalen Ramsey's rookie season. It's really close to what he did his rookie season. That's what I expect. I expect this dude to come out there and be a beast, okay? That's what I got for J.C. Horn. Next up, we got Terrace Marshall. Hold up. Let me do something. That's more like it. All right, next up we got Terrace Marshall. All right, Terrace Marshall. This guy is a guy I expect big things from, but maybe not immediately. I think it's gonna take some time. I think they're going to take their time with this guy, bring him along slowly. We still got Robbie Anderson. We still got DJ Moore. Still got David Moore. There's a bunch of guys out there that we have. And I think that they're going to take their time with him. They're not going to throw him out there immediately. And for me, the big comp for him is going to be Tre'Quan Smith for the Saints. If you look at Tre'Quan Smith over the past couple seasons, I think that's where his ceiling is this season. Next season and going forward in the future, whole nother ball game. But this season, I expect to bring him along a little slow, okay? So this is my official stat prediction for Terrace Marshall. Again, I got 22 receptions, 325 yards, and I got 2 touchdowns. And I think it's again, I know some of y'all gonna be like, man, he's gonna kill, he's gonna have way more touchdowns, he's a red zone threat, that's a little light. But I just think they're going to take it slow with the guy. There's no need for him to go out there and ball out this season. Now, later on, next year, and years after that, and going forward, I expect this man to be an absolute beast, okay? And I think that, you know, the comp where I want him to be in my head is Chris Godwin. If he can come out and be a Chris Godwin in year two, year three, year four, that's what I want to see, because I think that's where he can, that's who he can be. And I think he can be that compliment to DJ Moore moving forward. All right. Next up, we got Brady Christensen. Okay. Brady Christensen. This is a guy, again, taken in the third round, viewed as a third round tackle, second round guard. We found that out in Panthers Confidential. That's where they want him to be. But, you know, it is what it is, man. I think he's going to be a guard. He's going to come in and play, you know, some sets, and I don't know if they're gonna have a role for him defined immediately. They're gonna bring him along slow. I just don't see him playing tackle anytime soon. I think he could slide over to right tackle, maybe, because there's a lot of writing on the wall with Moten. They have not paid Moten yet, and a lot of people think that Moten may not get paid. Could he be the right tackle of the future? I don't know, but this season specifically, I don't expect much from Christensen. He's not going to play left tackle. Get that out your brain. Matt Rhule went out and said, yo, we got Irving, we got Daly, we got Little, and we got some other guys that they're going to compete for it. Okay, Trent Scott, he's going to compete for it. Didn't mention Christensen, okay? So I don't think he's going to be in the discussion for left tackle. And that, it just is what it is, okay? So I think he's going to be, he's going to come out in some guard some packages and play guard. But we're not going to see him at tackle this year unless there's some injuries, okay? If there's injuries, whole nother story. But there's no injuries, I just don't see happening for Christensen this year. All right, let's move on to Tommy Tremble. Hold up. One more thing. Much better. Tommy Tremble, okay? This is a guy that I think I'm going to akin him to Chris Manhurts. I know he wears the same number as Chris Manhurts, but he's really a blocking tight end. He's a blocking guy. He's working on becoming a full package tight end where he can catch the ball, but I don't expect to see that much this year. I think we have Dan Arnold. You hear Ian Thomas coming out having a good year. Now, if Ian Thomas gets cut, different story. I don't see that happening the way they're kind of, you know, speaking him up. I don't see him getting cut this year. But if he does get cut, that changes everything, because I think he's going to get way more involved. But Dan Arnold, I think he's going to get a lot of the receiving. And I think there's a lot of receivers to feed, personally. And you got DJ Moore, Robbie Anderson, Terrace Marshall, we just talked about, David Moore, Dan Arnold. It's a lot of guys. It's a lot of guys to feed, and I just don't think he's going to get involved much. Think in your head, think a combination between Alex Armour, who's going to block, Chris Manhurts, who's also a blocking type guy. I think that's going to be his role this year. Now, moving forward, it could expand where he becomes a full complete tight end, but I don't see that this year. I expect to see him in a blocking role to start out. And I wouldn't be surprised. I would not be surprised if he gets a couple carries. You could see them hand off the ball to him in some goal line or some short yard scenarios. You never know. That's my opinion on Tommy Tremble so far. All right, let's move on to Chuba Hubbard. Hold on one second. much better. Feel good now. All right, Chuba Hubbard. Now listen, I've already done a video about whether Christian McCaffrey is going to concede some of those snaps. We'll see what happens with that. I'm not quite sure, to be honest with you. But I'm going to do it based on what I would love to see personally if I'm running a team, because I need this guy to get some carries, okay? I need him to get involved, split the carries with Christian McCaffrey, keep Christian McCaffrey on the field, put him in a slot more, move him around, do some things, but get this man Chuba Hubbard the ball. So in my opinion, I think that Chuba Hubbard should get 119 carries this season. And I also think he's going to average 4.4 yards per carry, putting him at about 523 rushing yards. And I'll give him, you know, two or three touchdowns. Maybe he'll grab some goal line or something like that. Maybe a couple of receiving. I don't know. We'll see what happens. But I'll give him a couple touchdowns. That's how I need him to be used from a running back standpoint. I need them to split the carries up, give Christian McCaffrey a break. Keep him on the field, but give him a break from a running back perspective. Split the carries up. You need multiple running backs. Get them involved. You spent a fourth round pick on this guy. Now use him right. Use him, okay? Don't sit him on the bench. Use this man. So I've got 523 rushing yards, two or three touchdowns, something like that. At the end of the day, you invested a fourth round pick in this guy. Justify that fourth round pick by giving him the football, okay? Give him the football and let's see what happens. Split it up. Give him some burn, okay? All right, next up, we got Davion Nixon. Davion Nixon is a guy who I like a lot, and I don't have a jersey for him. That's my bad. That's oversight by me, okay? I'm sleeping because I think Davion Nixon is going to be a guy that's going to be impactful in the future for him. I think he's going to be really good. A guy like him is not going to impact the game like Bravion Roy did. I don't think he's going to have a Bravion Roy type season. Bravion Roy was good. He got a lot of opportunity due to injuries, okay? He got a lot of opportunity due to Kawan Short not being able to play. I don't think that's going to happen this year. I think you got Daquan Jones, you got Derrick Brown, you got Bravion Roy, and I think there's going to be a nice little rotation there. So I don't expect him to come out and be a beast, but I do expect him to come out there and make an impact. Whether it's, you know, pressures, maybe he gets one sack. If he can come out and be what F.A. Obada was, that would be great. That would be great. Fantastic. And I don't expect that. May be a little bit lofty, to be honest with you. But from an interior standpoint, and I know they're not going to play the same role. But if he can do what F.A. Obada did, that would be awesome. And I would love that from Davion Nixon. Don't sleep on Davion Nixon. I think he's a bit of a sleeper. People are overlooking him, such as myself, because I don't even have a jersey for him. Got to make that happen. All right, next up, we got Keith Taylor. Now, Keith Taylor is a guy that I don't think we're going to see much this year. There's a lot of guys in front of him, and I just think he's going to be a special teams contributor this year. So that's all I got for him, because I think there's a long road. You got guys like A.J. Bouye, Dante Jackson, Troy Pride, J.C. Horn. There's a lot of guys in front of him that he's got a long road to climb, okay? He's got a long hill to get up, and this year, I just don't think we're going to see him. Next year is where I think we get the push from Keith Taylor. Dante Jackson may or may not be around, and I think that Troy Pride, we're going to know for sure what we have in Troy Pride by then, and I think he could potentially push Troy Pride, and I think that's where you're going to see him. It's going to be him, Keith Taylor, it's going to be Keith Taylor, J.C. Horn, and A.J. Bouye. That's a great threesome as far as cornerbacks. Pause. That's a great threesome as far as cornerbacks goes, all right? So that's all I got for Keith Taylor. And maybe even year three before we see what we have in Keith Taylor. So just be patient with Keith Taylor, but he's a big, big cornerback. And I expect big things from him in the future, not this year. 1 second. Much better. Whew. Deontay Brown, my guy, out of Alabama. Big 7'7", yes. Now I know y'all gonna ask me where I get these jerseys from. Hit me on Twitter, hit me in the email. Email's in the description box, I'll let y'all know. But I can't tell y'all over, I gotta connect, but I can't tell y'all. Hit me up if you want a jersey, all right? So, Deontay Brown. This dude's primarily gonna be used in goal line and short yardage situations. I don't expect him to come out there and be a starter this year. But in the future, if he can get his pass sets right, if he can get his pass protection up, this dude is going to be an absolute beast. And I know y'all saying, Shy, he didn't give up no sacks at Alabama. Well, it worked. The offensive line works together, right? If you got a good left tackle, you got a good center, I think you're going to be taken care of. And I don't know. One-on-one, I think you're going to be able to beat him with speed, and he's going to have to adjust from a speed standpoint to the NFL. So I don't know that he's going to be able to do that his rookie season. Next year, maybe he becomes a starter. And I think he can be an absolute monster. If this dude can control his weight, he's going to be a beast, okay? He is going to be an absolute beast. And I cannot wait to see him road grade somebody. Pause. I cannot wait to see him knock somebody 10 yards down the field. I cannot wait. I'm ready for it. I know I'm going to see it this year because they're going to have some packages for him. There's no way under God's green earth that we should not be converting 4th-and-1, 3rd-and-1, 3rd-and-goal. 4th-and-goal. We should be getting all of those. Run right behind this dude, and you should get a dub every single time. All right, next up, we got Shai Smith. And I know there's a ton of excitement around Shai Smith, and I do have a jersey on the way. I haven't gotten it yet, but I really like this kid. I think we have to be patient, though. There's a lot of hype around the dude. A lot of people want to see him go out there and be a beast. This year, it's just not going to happen. There's too many guys ahead of him. Unless some of those guys get cut, maybe Robbie Anderson gets cut or something like that. I don't know. Not cut or traded. If Robbie Anderson is not on the roster in some way, shape, or form, then maybe he gets an opportunity. But there's a lot of guys ahead of him. David Moore, DJ Moore, Terrace Marshall, Brandon. There's a lot of guys in front of him. And I just, maybe he gets some love this year, but it's not going to be a lot. His main contribution is going to be his special teams. Hopefully he gets an opportunity to return some kicks. That would be great, but we're just not going to see a lot of him this year. And I think he's going to make the team. I just don't know that we're going to see him dress a lot of days come game day. So that's just my opinion. Again, down the road, maybe year two, year three, maybe he can get some Damir Bird-like love, okay? You see him push the field, he's stretched the field out, got some speed to him. Maybe we can see that then. But this year, I just don't see it. A lot of contribution this year. All right, so next up, we got Thomas Fletcher. And no, I do not have a Thomas Fletcher jersey, so don't ask. However, I do have a bet on the line somewhere that I will get a jersey if he makes the roster and he pushes J.J. Jansen out the window. And that is my prediction for him. I do think he is going to push J.J. Jansen out and will become our long snapper for the next 15 years, okay? I'm hoping if we use the sixth-round pick on this dude and drafted him over Trey Smith, that this guy is somebody we can put in for the next 15 years and not have to worry about it. And my prediction is that he's not going to have any missed snaps or any messed up snaps. He's going to be a beast, the best long snapper in the league. That's my prediction for Thomas Fletcher, all right? All right, next up, we got Phil Hoskins. And Phil Hoskins is a guy I think that's going to end up on the practice squad. I think he's going to get cut. They'll bring him back. He's not going to make the initial 53. With a rotation like Davion Nixon, Bravion Roy, Daquan Jones, and Derrick Brown, I just don't see any room for this cap. But so we'll see. We'll see. I think he ends up on the practice squad, though. All right. That being said, hold up. One more. Much better. Y'all thought I was going to forget? Y'all thought I was going to forget about David Moore? Nah, that's my guy. Shout out to David Moore. HBCU love. Shout out to Grambling. Shout out to all the HBCU graduates and all that good stuff. David Moore, this is a guy who I expect to make the roster, end up being our backup center. No problem. I think he's going to be a beast. Have you seen this dude's calf muscles? Pause. All right. This dude's calf muscles are amazing. They're like tree trunks, bro. This dude is going to be a beast. Should have got drafted. He's going to prove to y'all why he should have been drafted this year. It's no excuse for this man not to be drafted. He's going to come out there. He's going to use that as fuel every single down. He's going to be a beast. He's going to be a center of the future. Watch out for David Moore. That's my thoughts on David Moore. That's my thoughts on all the rookies this year. Listen, make sure y'all hit that like button, hit the subscribe button, hit the notification bell, get in these comments. If you're on Newsbreak, make sure you like over there. Go download the Newsbreak app. Man, I love y'all. And if you ask me for a jersey in the comments without doing what I said do, I'm going to know you didn't watch the whole video. All right, so watch the whole video. Find out how to get a jersey or get in contact with me about jerseys. So holla at me, all right? That being said, I'm out.